Did you know there's a building in Long Beach that once used to house a 200-ton airplane, was used as a soundstage for major motion pictures, and even as a roller derby rink? History is all around us. Sometimes it gets a little lost. This is Discovered History. Completed in 1983, the Spruce Goose Dome was built to house the Spruce Goose, a giant wooden airplane designed by the one and only Howard Hughes. Originally known as the Hercules H-04, the plane, built of wood, weighed 400,000 pounds, had 8 engines, and a wingspan of over 300 feet. That's longer than a football field. Conceived to transport troops and military equipment during World War II, the plane was not completed until 1947, long after the war ended. After much controversy, it flew only once at an altitude of 70 feet for approximately 1 mile above the waters off Long Beach. After that, it sat in storage for over 30 years at the Port of Long Beach. Fast forward to 1983. The Goose was brought out of storage by its new owner, the Ryder Corporation, and needed a new home. And now a plane like that needed a really big building to house it. How about a dome? The Ryder Corporation commissioned Torrance-based Temco to build what at the time was the world's largest clear-span dome. Finished in a matter of months for $4 million, the aluminum dome has a base diameter of 415 feet and rises 130 feet into the air, equivalent to a 12-story building. The exterior consists of 4,000 triangular-shaped panels finished with ivory-colored fluoropolymer paint. While the Goose was on display inside the dome, visitors could also see a brief history of the plane's creator, Howard Hughes, along with the light and laser special effects show, Time Voyager. The show, which featured interactive elements along with 3D visuals, took visitors on a time travel adventure that contained pig-like aliens called Orbons. Sadly, the show only ran for a short time. For 10 years, the giant plane made its home here in Long Beach. But in 1992, it was moved to McMinnville, Oregon, where it remains to this day. So Long Beach was left with a giant empty dome. What do you put in a giant empty dome?
Because of its giant open space, the dome was used as a soundstage for movies like Last Action Hero, Jack Frost, and most famously, the 1995 classic Batman Forever. Inside the dome, Long Beach-born visual effects supervisor John Dykstra, along with production designer Barbara Ling, were able to create Batman's Batcave, rising over 60 feet above the dome's floor. This allowed for the Batmobile to rise on a turntable and make for one of the film's most memorable moments. Other sets built in the dome included Bruce Wayne's offices, along with the interiors of stately Wayne Manor.
For those playing along at home, that's the Batman with Val Kilmer, not George Clooney. It also housed roller derby matches, the holiday event Chill, which featured intricate ice sculptures, and mazes for the Queen Mary's Halloween event, Dark Harbor. All those things were just temporary until 2016, when the Carnival Cruise Line began using part of it as a boarding facility, eventually expanding to use the entire space in 2017. As a nod to the dome's past, when Carnival remodeled the terminal, they included a giant model of Hughes' flying boat. This architectural and historical marvel has been an iconic part of the Long Beach skyline for more than 30 years. Will the future be just as interesting? We'll have to wait and see. Till next time, I'm Kurt A. Eichstedt, and this was Discovered History.